Here is the decline in popularity of the Roman pontiff, here is his failure, which appears increasingly evident as evidenced by his current trip to Ireland. Now in Ireland while he is speaking, archbishops of his church on the same day, have revealed that he himself is the first to cover the abuses, to have covered the abuses of an eminent American cardinal and then invites him to resign to put into practice what he says that others guilty of such abuses must do. Here everything manifests itself and that everything becomes more and more evident, here those words launched for pure propaganda now like a boomerang come back and they hit frontally him and those who gave birth to this deception. If the Roman pontiff really wanted to help the Irish Catholic people now that in Ireland, he would have moved before, and he should have gone first to Ireland when it was time to vote for the referendum on abortion, rather than keeping quiet. If you want to solve problems you fight first, going after it is useless if not to make propaganda and show your mistakes. Who cares about Christianity, defends it first, during the battle. What good is it to move now if not to certify the death of the family wanted by God in favor of other forms of family that are not family? Many have understood the mere action of propaganda of the Roman pontiff who promotes an anti-Christian spirit. One cannot organize meetings that are only apparently for Christian families, but which in reality are a tribute to the spirit of Antichrist, recalling with the symbol of 666 present in the letter, stylized in the logo of the meeting and with speeches by priests activists of homosexual movements. That house has lost contact with God, this is reality and so many have realized it and are no longer willing to do human favors for that house, to cover. This is why the controversy increase as well as today in all evidence in every newspaper is happening, here is the earthly justice advances, highlighting the real dimension of the abomination of pedophilia. Not isolated cases, but a real, world plague, which has already hit entire continents, peoples and nations. America with the United States and Canada to the north. Chile where the whole episcopate has resigned because of this. Argentina and Brazil to the south, Oceania with trials and convictions in Australia, and thus Europe that was once the cradle of Christianity. Many nations are affected by this scandal just to mention those that the recent news has highlighted, Ireland, Austria, Belgium, Spain, the Netherlands, Germany, Switzerland, Malta, United Kingdom, France, and Italy. But the list is long and other continents and nations will be severely affected by these scandals. The Father has turned his gaze from that house, and without the protection of the Father everything will manifest itself more and more, because that is what the Father wants. Because the Father wants to manifest to his children the true nature of this house, which must be highlighted, so that many can understand the truth. Only this way so many will open their eyes, and awakened from a terrible and mortal sleep, they will understand that the Spirit of God no longer dwells in that house. From the feeling of initial amazement they will pass to that of disgust, and many will understand the involvement of the summit of that house, not only of priests operating in the suburbs as it has been publicly denounced. The Roman pontiff directly denounced by the one who was an apostolic nuncio in the United States who knew that reality well for covering for several years, abuses perpetrated by an eminent cardinal who remained in his place thanks to the cover-up of the Roman pontiff.